Let's be honest, VBA user forms can look kind of old school, and they take quite a lot of time and know-how to build. So if you want to make a decent looking entry form, you will end up spending quite a bit of time on it. Also, AI tools like ChatGPT won't help because they can't design or create the form for you. But what if I told you there's actually a way to create modern looking data entry forms for Excel without writing a single line of code? Well, there is, because I built a drag and drop form builder. You just drag and drop the elements you want in your form, hit one button, and voila, you got a clean and modern form. It comes with drop-down boxes, checkboxes, radio buttons, and even a date picker. There is no VBA needed, and it works on any machine. And best of all, you don't have to install anything. Oh, and it's completely free. So let us jump right in and let me show you the solution I created for you. So to get started, head over to my website. You will find the link down in the description box. Once you're there, you will see the data entry form builder. On the left side, you will find all the different field types. To start building your form, just drag and drop the fields into this section right here. For my form, I'm using a text field, an email field, a number field, a date picker, a drop down, and also a checkbox. Now that you've added your fields, you can click on any of them to adjust their properties, like adding a label. As you start typing the label, you will also see it updates the card name, so that makes it a little bit easier if you want to reorder your fields later on. Also, you can add a placeholder value, some helper text, and you can mark the field as required. So in my case, I'm gonna go ahead and make this one actually required. Alright, next up, let me adjust the email field. I will add a label, a placeholder, and I will mark it as required too. Now for the phone number field, I'm gonna add a little helper text. So this will show up right under the input and give the user a little bit of guidance. For the date field, I will just update the label and leave the rest as it is. Okay, and now let's move on to the select box. So for select boxes, radio buttons, and also checkboxes, you can type your options down here. The top field is what the user sees in the form, and the one below is the value that gets actually saved to your Excel file. Now by default, when you fill out the option label, it also fills the value automatically. So it turns everything in lowercase and replaces spaces with underscores. So that can help later if you're planning to work with the data. But of course, if you want, you can always change your value yourself. Okay, so with that said, let me go ahead and fill out the second option. Now, if you want, you can also add more options by clicking this button right here. Or if you want to remove an option, just click this icon. Alright, so lastly, let me adjust the checkbox fields. This works pretty much the same as before. So I will update the label here and fill out the two options. Now, of course, you could also have a checkbox with only one option. Like I mentioned earlier, if you only want one, you can simply remove the second one by clicking the little X right here. But in my case, I do want to actually keep the two options. Okay, and with that all in place, you can still reorder or remove any of the fields. To remove a field, just click on the X here. And to move a field around, click and hold down the left mouse button and then drag it where you want it. So let's move the date field to the bottom of the form. Once you let go of the mouse button, it will drop right where your cursor is. Alright, and now let's go ahead and generate the form by clicking this button here. Up here at the top, you will also have the option now to change the title and the description of the user form. So this will show up above the form when it's displayed. But don't worry, you can change this and also all the other fields later on too. Also, you will notice that when you start typing, those changes will instantly show up in the JSON output right here. Alright, now all we need to do is to download the entry form. Just click this button and the zip folder will be downloaded. By default, it should go straight to your downloads folder. So let me navigate there. First, we need to extract the archive. Just right-click on the zip file and select Extract All. Once that is done, go to the extracted folder. Here you will find the entry form as an HTML file and also the quick start guide as a PDF. So let me go ahead and open the HTML file. Alright, and this is now your entry form. And just a quick note here. This is a local site, which means it's running directly on your machine. So no data is sent anywhere. Also, you should know that this one right here is just a template file. That means the input fields you see here are just some sample data. So to use our custom form, go back to my website and copy the generated JSON to your clipboard. Then come back to your user form and click on the form settings. Here you will want to replace the default form with your custom one. So I will press Ctrl and A to select everything and then hit the delete key. Now I will paste in our custom form by pressing Ctrl and V. Okay, and with that, I will click on Apply Changes. Alright, and now here it is, our custom data entry form. We've got the title, the description, our name and email fields, the number input, the drop-down menu, the checkboxes, and the date field. You will also see a little red asterisk next to the required inputs, the placeholders, and the helper text we added. So with that, let me go ahead and fill out the form. First up, we've got a simple text input. Next is the email field. This one works kinda like a text field, but it has built-in email validation. So as you start typing, it will check if the format looks like a valid email address. After that, we've got the number input. That means you can only enter numbers in this field. Below that, we've got the drop-down menu and the checkboxes. Now, just as a side note here, if you only wanted one selectable option, you would use a radio button instead. Okay. And finally, we've got the date picker field. So when you click on it, it will open a calendar where you can pick a date. Alright, and now that everything is filled out, let's add the entry. Since we haven't connected it to an existing spreadsheet yet, it's gonna ask us to select a folder where we wanna save the spreadsheet. So I will go ahead and save it to my current directory, which is the downloads folder. Once that is confirmed, you will see a success message popping up in the bottom right corner. And you will also see that our entry shows up right here in the user form. And just to double check that it was actually saved to my spreadsheet, let me take a look at my current directory. And yep, here it is, our new workbook. So when you open it, here's what it looks like. You will see the label names are now used as headers, and right below that is our entry. Also, you will notice that the subscription type value is in lowercase, just like we set it when we configured the form. Alright, now to show you a few more features, let me go back to our form and add another entry. So now after filling out all the fields, when I press the Add Entry button, we won't be asked again where to save the file, and that's because we are already connected to our spreadsheet. So now we've got two entries in our workbook. Now of course, once you have more entries, you might want to hide this list right here. And you can easily do that by clicking this button. Also, if you want to search for a specific record, you can use a search box right here. As soon as you start typing, the list will automatically filter. Alright, and with that, let me also show you another neat feature. If you scroll a bit to the right, you will see an action column. This is where you can update entries. Just click on the edit icon and it will pull the data from the spreadsheet and fill out the form fields for you. So now this makes it super easy for changes. For example, I will remove the updates option under the preferences. After you're done with editing, just click on the update button. And now you can see that the record has been updated. And by the way, you can also delete any entry directly from the user form. For that, just click on the little trash icon right here. Now, when you delete something, you will be asked to confirm, so I will go ahead and click on OK here. Alright, and now you can see that the entry has been indeed deleted. We can also double check that by going back to our spreadsheet. So when I reopen the workbook, this is what it looks like. Our second entry is gone and the preferences have been updated. Now, of course, you don't have to use the user form to add, update or delete entries. You can do all of that also directly in Excel. That also means if you already have existing data, you can just copy and paste it right here into this sheet. Okay, and lastly, let me also show you what happens if you refresh a website. So you will see that reloading the page disconnects us from the spreadsheet. And if you scroll down, you will notice that the entries are no longer visible as we are not connected anymore. However, our form settings, like our input fields, are still intact. And that's because they are saved in the browser's cache. So to reconnect to our spreadsheet, just click the Connect Spreadsheet button. Here, I will now select the same workbook we used earlier. And once we are connected, all our entries will show up again in the form. Okay, and before we wrap up, let me also show you that you can adjust your form anytime later on. To do that, just go to the form settings. Here, you can make changes directly in the JSON file, like updating a label, changing the input type, adding a placeholder, and so on and so forth. In my case, I will just change the title. Once you're done, click on Apply and the form will update right away. Okay, and lastly, let me also show you the most important feature of all, dark mode. So you can switch between the light and the dark themes by clicking this button right here. Okay, and with that, you have pretty much seen all the most important features. So next up, let's also talk a few limitations. As I mentioned earlier, the whole form runs locally on your machine. Because of that, your browser can access your files, so it can read and write to a spreadsheet. To make that work, it uses something like the File System Access API. Now, this API isn't supported in every browser. So if you want to use the user form, I highly recommend using Chrome or Edge. Because if you try to open the file in Firefox, for example, and connect it to a spreadsheet, you will get an error message, just like the one shown here. Lastly, I also want to point out that I have another form builder on my website. This one, on the other hand, generates Python code for you. And the idea is quite similar. You use a form builder to design your form, and when you're done, you can export it. But this time you will get a Python file that includes everything you need for a standalone GUI application. And also with this app, you can create, read, update and delete records. So if that sounds interesting to you, feel free to check out that page on my website. And I will also make a dedicated video about it soon. Alright, and with that we are pretty much at the end of the video. And now I'm really curious to know what you think about these form builders. Let me know in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.